of San Francisco's top developers are getting their hands on the Bose AR SDK for Unity.
We invited developers, composers, and designers from all over the Bay Area to come build a Bose AR game experience with an audio-first approach.
The challenge that Bose presented us with is to create an AR experience game where the audio is the main component of the gameplay.
We really have to develop a game around spatial audio cues.
We can have sound coming at us from any direction, and to be able to design this world with that in mind is really, really neat.
Thinking about how you can make environments with sound that aren't relying on your visual senses so that your imagination is filling in the story is something that's really compelling as a creator.
Audio is, of course, a very powerful storytelling medium, and making interactive audio experiences is even more so.
Blood Rails is a train arcade game set in the post-apocalypse where trains have covered the entire planet in rails, and the human survivors have to evade trains hunting them wildly across the ruined landscape. When a train is coming at you, you hear it via spatial audio. They circle the way sharks do, which is, you know, the way trains move. Once they hone in on you, they'll pursue you directly. So it's up to you to time your dodges carefully to move aside at the last moment. And by doing that, you reload your laser glasses, and then you can use the laser glasses to blast the train.
We created a spatial audio adventure where you are trying to unscramble the Oracle to help your fairy chicken godmother locate her husband and children.
We're walking through an enchanted forest. We're measuring the player's cadence, you know, using Bose AR. You get to meet different characters and make choices along the way that affect the story's outcome, kind of like an old-fashioned radio play, but interactive.
Our game's called Quack. You hear a beat, and it's sort of a Simon Says thing, so it's gonna give you a series of directions. It's like look left, look right, like up, down.
And then you repeat those back to the beat of the music.
Our game is a multiplayer co-op game where one player is wearing the audio device and the other one is on the phone.
The person with the glasses will listen for the monster using spatial audio, and then they shoot a beam at it by tapping on the glasses. And then once they've sealed it in place, then the player on the tablet will draw a magical symbol which seals the demon away, and then it's defeated.
Our game is War of the Worlds Tripod Invasion. The player will move through a series of dodges of the alien heat ray. So they're essentially playing games like hopscotch or red light, green light. So they have to move based on audio cues, and then they have to freeze. Or if they freeze, they'll die. And when they free the prisoners, they get latte points.
I'm very excited to see what this technology will eventually become.
There's nothing more perfect than pushing the envelope with how we hear and how we do spatial audio and how we change how we interact with our different senses.
It's a lot of fun to be able to create new ways to experience the real world through sound. It just drives so much innovation and creativity and brings the community together in a way that fosters more ideas and more connections.